Well, good morning and welcome to your Sunday Gardener. I'm John Collins along with Carrie Engel
good
from
morning.
Valley View Farms. We're going to get back to nature today.
There
but
you
we
go.
Deal with Mother Nature an awful lot, but this is natural, or native maybe is a more appropriate term for what we're going to talk about this morning.
Exactly. As we put up more buildings, more highways, more parking lots, we've lost some native species of plants, and because we've lost some native species of plants, we've lost some native species of animals as well.
Mm-hmm.
So it's becoming more and more important to plant natives and to really have a home for some of the native habitat, or to create a native habitat for some of these animals.
And more importantly, these plants work very well in this environment. The summer heat and humidity,
right.
Some of the diseases and
somewhat deer-resistant,
right,
yeah.
and some of the bugs that they work with and work against.
Exactly,
you know.
Exactly.
So a native has a lot going for it.
And there are some what we call nativars, so they're native plants, but they have cultivars with them. So we don't really differentiate that much between that.
Mm-hmm.
If you want a great list, go to the National U.S. Wildlife Service, Fish
mm-hmm.
and Wildlife Service, and they have a wonderful listing of native plants that you can take with you and really shop at your favorite nursery and really determine what's great for your yard.
Okay, let's take a look at a few here very quickly.
These are great. This is lobelia. The one that I'm most familiar with is the cardinal red lobelia that
mm-hmm.
grows nice and tall. This is great for a shade or a woodland garden. This is a little blue stem, this grass back here. Some of the grasses can be invasive. This is one that does not. It really stays nice.
So it's a nice ornamental.
Absolutely. Yep.
We're talking perennials here, right?
These are
yes.
all perennials, yeah. Down here, if you feel this stem, it's a square stem.
Oh.
And that's sort of indicative that it's a member of the mint family. This is Monarda, also called bee balm. And when we started here, we still have a bee flying around.
Right.
So that helps bring some pollinators in the garden. Down here in front of me, this is Asclepias. This is the must-have plant for monarch butterflies. Asclepias tuberosa
mm-hmm.
is a plant that they'll go to time and time again. Spigelia down here next to it. This is another wonderful native.
Yeah.
And that's a flower. I think that's just interesting. You don't see a flower that often.
Right.
Our
right,
own black-eyed
right.
Susan, of course, is native. I call these the hell plants. They're either Hellenium Mardi Gras.
Sneezeweed.
That's right.
So maybe I ought to stay away from that.
But all sorts of ferns, like the hay-scented fern, is also mm-hmm. native in our area. Back here is Zytea. This will give you some great fall color. The birds love it. Down here, the Heuchera-type plants
mm-hmm.
are very good.
They
and
do well in my yard, I know that.
Yep.
What's this guy, this tall guy back here?
We named
here?
This after our photographer. This is Joe Pieweed. This is a wonderful plant. Gets nice and tall.
Uh-huh.
Swallowtails absolutely love it.
Really?
Yeah.
Really?
It
all right, and it'll come
that.
Back year after year after year.
Exactly. So all sorts of things. For other resources, go to some of our native areas, things
mm-hmm.
like Irvine Nature Center.
What do they have to offer?
They've got a nice native plant walks. They've got camps for kids. They just have all sorts of things that you can do. And they're over in the Owings Mills area.
Mm-hmm.
Right up here, we have Oregon Ridge, right up by Hunt Valley. So
right.
there are a lot of neat places. Get out, get the kids out away from their electronic devices and enjoy some of nature.
And learn about what's going on here. I knew the Heuchera and this fern really thrive in my yard, and I didn't have much to do with it. I mean, I planted a couple of Heucheras. There are many more now, and the fern just kind of came up on its own.
Exactly, and that's
yeah.
what's nice. Like you said, they work with our native soils. They work with things that we have there, and they'll just go to town.
Okay, Carrie, thanks a lot.
Thank you.
Going native on Sunday Gardener. It makes for easy gardening. I think that's one good thing. Next Sunday, we'll be back with more. We'll see you then.
And if you have a gardening question, send it to Sunday Gardener, WBAL-TV, 3800 Hooper Avenue, Baltimore, Maryland, 21211.